And Jackie here and our friends at Stivers Ford Lincoln, downright proud to salute some great organizations in town and introduce you to an organization you might not know existed.
Absolutely. So how about Iowa Elite Bats? Have you heard of that before? Well, you are going to do that right now as we introduce you to the gentleman who founded this great organization and wants to make sure you know about it today. That's Keon Patton. Thank you so much for being here. And president of the organization, Tori Patton, joining us as well. So let's go back here a little bit. What is Iowa Elite Bats?
Iowa Elite Bats is an advanced baseball training skills program. It's an all-year program where we like to train all year round. And like I said, we train in advanced skills in baseball. So it's a high competitive level play of U-SSSA competitive baseball.
Okay, who is this designed for? What age people is this designed for?
It's designed for ages anywhere from 4 years old to
4 years old?
4 years old all the way up to 18 can benefit from this program. Yes, sir.
Right. Okay, so you're the founder
of it. I am
the
founder.
Why was this important to have in our area?
It was important to me as a minority to bring baseball back to the minority youth because they are sold, you know, a lot to basketball and football. And those jobs to me were limited through size and, you know, different things like that, different challenges. Baseball doesn't present those challenges. Size doesn't matter. It's only as big as you play. So you can pick any position on the field. If you can play big, that's your position. You know, in basketball, you have to be 7 foot. You're not going to be down low if you're not 7 foot. So there's some restrictions to those sports of basketball and football. So I wanted to bring baseball to the inner city youth. And
so you found a void.
Absolutely.
In some of the entertainment and some of the sporting activities the inner city youth could participate in and do so at a high level. And I think that's the key, is at an upper level, right?
Yes, sir.
I love that idea. I've never thought about that before, that there are restrictions with certain sports if you want to get to a certain level,
right.
Or maybe even just in a school format. Sometimes you're put to the side because you're not a certain size or you're not a certain weight.
You're not big enough for the football or basketball team.
Right.
Even now, it's big enough for the basketball team because you need some stature to play basketball competitively nowadays. But Tori, this is an amazing organization. What made you so interested in getting involved in something like this?
Well, mostly my husband. I do most of the paperwork and the behind-the-scenes things for the BATS program, so...
So it was important to make something like this successful.
It was, and also we wanted to really focus on the minority groups because I feel like there was a lot of programs for other children that wasn't happening for the minorities.
So how are you, besides being on our program this morning, how are you reaching out to kids to make sure they know that this exists in our area?
Well, we have a lot of flyers that we like to hand out, and we go to different places like the Y.
Great.
I don't know where else we are.
Yeah, just trying to get out and about in the community. Yeah.
So if there's some folks that are watching right now, maybe they have some kids that are out there anywhere between 4 and 18 years old that may have showed a little interest in baseball, this is something you want to do. And what's the best way to get a hold of you guys so they can find out when the programs are being offered?
We have a Facebook webpage called Iowa Elite Bats. You can look us up on that. Also, there's flyers all throughout the city that we put up in various places that where minorities, you know, primarily located. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, through those avenues, you can probably find us.
Kind of find us. Now, you said this is year-round. Are there certain entry level or when you can come in and start, or is it year-round? You can come on over and check it
just
out.
Jump
year-round, jump in anytime.
Anytime.
Our program is just that simple. I mean, you can jump in anytime. And those things are relevant to what you're probably doing right now. And if you're behind, we catch you up to where the kids are.
Excellent.
Our motto is not to leave no kid behind. We do not cut players. We put everybody where their level of play and where they can be successful.
All right. We'd be remiss if we didn't ask you what it stands for. You can see it says Iowa Elite Bats, B-A-T-S, with little periods after there. What does the B-A-T-S stand for?
The BAT stands for Baseball Advanced Training Skills, and that's what we're all about. We want to take our games to a higher level of play. Also, I'd like to touch on that we're a nonprofit organization, and that we really plan on trying to make the inner city park safer by bringing baseball to those inner city parks and resurrecting some of those parks that
Absolutely.
Are not being used.
What a great idea.
Yeah, so that's our main objective.
Now, where are you doing all this training? Where are you guys located?
Right now, we're located at 2525 Hubble Avenue on the east side of Des Moines.
Okay.
It's the Iowa Elite Basketball and Baseball Facility. So we've been blessed to be able to train indoor when the weather's not agreeing with us, and then we go outside when the weather is playable.
Okay, now give people an idea of where this is located over on Hubble there. What's some of the landmarks in the area?
There is a fire department. There's Teach Out swimming pool.
Okay, sure.
Big Kmart is closing right at this moment, but we're right
that's
on
in
the
that
east
general
side
area.
Of, and the fairgrounds, not to mention the fair is right in that area as well.
Okay, so when you're heading over there in August, you might want to stop by and
there
see
you
what
go.
It's all
take
about.
Take that route to go by.
You mentioned being a nonprofit. That means you're probably always seeking an assistance for making sure that this program goes strong as well.
Yes, ma'am. That's another reason why we're here today, that to try to generate funding and get funding and sponsorships to drive that cost down. That's another thing that affects the minority groups and drives them out of baseball is the cost. The cost is so high, we want to try to drive that down by getting the word out there to the city and the people and letting them know that we're serious and we're committed and that they should invest in us and help us drive that cost down and present this opportunity to the minority kids.
What kind of cost is it to the people that want to participate? Is it vary?
It varies. We have a couple payment plan options. I mean, it's straight across the board at the moment, you know, a fixed rate.
But again, this is a nonprofit, though.
Just it is.
Keep that in mind. So the costs are just the maintenance type costs.
Yes, sir. Okay. Maintenance to keep the doors, the lights open, and uniforms on the kids' backs.
There you go.
That's pretty much it.
Well, explain to me if there was a 4-year-old that just wanted to play, maybe didn't have all the greatest skills in the world, but just was excited to be a part of an organization like this. What would you be training them at that young age?
We put them right into what we're doing with the 18-year-olds. We have balance boards and things like that to keep them
from falling. Well, I could pitch to a 4-year-old and I'd strike them out.
And we have live video feeds as well that we post on our Facebook page. So you can see some of those 4- and 5-year-olds or even 18-year-olds in action.
Oh, cool.
So you can see what they're doing. You can see that they're doing the same things as the 18-year-olds. We're just planting those seeds early and then let them grow by the time
what
they're 18.
What an awesome idea.
And besides gaining skills, what are you guys seeing in these young athletes as they are part of the program?
Well, we do teach them to be respectful, so everyone has to answer yes, ma'am, no, ma'am, yes, sir, no, sir. And by putting a minority leader in charge, they see someone that looks like them, which sometimes they weren't getting. So they're learning a different level of respect, maybe have a father figure that they didn't have before. So that's really important.
It's very important. That's amazing.
What a great job. Okay, so when's the next session coming up?
Monday. We practice Sundays, Mondays, and Wednesdays. So we practice this evening today at 5:30 to 7:30 on the east side of Des Moines.
So if people want to come check it out, they can come check it out.
They can come check it out.
That wonderful. Well, simple. The biggest thing I'd say is probably go to the Facebook page, Iowa Elite Bats, and see what it's all about, watch some videos, and see if maybe this is something you want to invest in so it can continue to grow strong. And love that idea of, revitalizing some baseball fields and getting kids out there to play.
Yes, ma'am. You know, those parks are driven with violence and drugs, and we just want to make them a safer place.
Absolutely.
What they were made and use them for what they were made for.
Use baseball to get there.
Yeah,
and use baseball as another avenue to get there.
All right.
Coach K, thank you, buddy.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it. Appreciate it.